सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुं समस्तजनकल्याणी निरतं करुणामयम् नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। ओम अखंडमंडलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुदेवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देवा त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देवा। ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। हरिओम। We will sing one bhajan of Bhagavan Shiva. To know Shiva, we need Shiva's grace. So we must invoke his blessings. This is a bhajan of Chinmaya Mission. Shankara Chandra Shekhara Gangadhara Sumanohara Pahi Mam Parameshwara Mrutyunjaya Vishveshwara शंकराचंद्रशेखरा गंगाधरा सुमनोहरा पाहि मां परमेश्वर मृत्युंजय विश्वेश्वरा। नीलकंठ फालनेत्र भस्मभूषित सुंदरा नीलकंठ फालनेत्र भस्मभूषित सुंदरा पाहि मां करुणाकर गिरिजेश ओंकारेश्वरा। शंकरा चंद्रशेखरा गंगाधरा सुमनोहरा पाहि मां परमेश्वर मृत्युंजय विश्वेश्वरा। तांडव प्रिय जय नटेश विश्वनाथ महेश्वर तांडव प्रिय जय नटेश विश्वनाथ महेश्वर पाहि मां अभयंकर व्याघ्र चरमांबरधरा शंकरा चंद्रशेखरा गंगाधरा सुमनोहरा पाहि मां परमेश्वर मृत्युंजय विश्वेश्वर मृत्युंजय विश्वेश्वर। ओम हर हर नमः पार्वतीपते हर हर महादेव। कर्पूरगौरं करुणावतारं संसारसारं भुजगेन्द्रहारं सदा वसन्तं हृदयारविन्दे भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि भवं भवानी सहितं नमामि। हरि। इन अवर गुरु परंपरा गुरु एंड गॉड बोथ आर वन। देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन गुरु एंड गॉड। गुरु एव दैवं दैवमेव गुरुः। समटाइम्स दैवम ओनली वी कैन ट्रीट एज गुरु आर वी कैन ट्रीट अवर गुरु एज दैवम। Swamiji, when it started, Swamiji, this sampradaya, Guru and God both are same. Actually, our parampara started with Bhagavan Shiva. That's why we pray Sadasiva Samarambham, Shankaracharya Madhyamam, Asmadacharya Paryantam, Vande Guru Paramparam. This Guru Parampara started with Sadasiva. Sadasiva is Trilokadipati. At the same time, he is a teacher of all arts. And Brahma Vidya also from him only. This is the cream of all knowledges. This is the essence of all knowledges. Upanishad says, all knowledges, what we study, what we read, and what we reflect, they all should lead to this Atma Jnanam only. Then Swamiji, who is the first one realized this Atma Jnanam? Atma only can realize Atma Jnanam. Aina? So that Atma Swarupa, Bhagavan, Sadguru is this Parameshwar. And many Mahatmas, they realize Brahman. They know their Atma Sthiti and they know their Satya Swarupam, true nature. But they are not ready to teach. They don't want to become teachers. Swamiji, what is wrong with to become a teacher? If he is an Atmajnani, he is a Atma Kridi, self-santoshi. He can sit anywhere, he can enjoy. But whereas the student comes, if he wants to be a teacher, okay, without student, nobody can be teacher. The status of student is always he is an ignorant fellow. He wants to maintain his status and he wants to support his own knowledge, which is completely wrong. Guru has to lift him. A lot of effort is needed. In Viveka Chodamani, Gurudev wants to say, this is like, you know, the student, he is drowning in the water. If Guru wants to save him, Gurudev very jokingly, he used to say, the guru must tie his langota very tight. Because the students want to catch his langota, and he will bring the guru also for his status. Aina? So guru has to protect himself. And whereas the samsara sagara also there. And he has to lift the student up and put him in the shore. That's why many Mahatmas, they are not ready to teach. But Bhagavan Shankara, he is the first teacher of this Brahma Vidya. In which form, Swamiji, he taught this Brahma Vidya? That form only, Dakshina Murti. The guru form of Bhagavan Shankara is nothing other than Dakshina Murti. Many other forms are there. One is called Nataraja Murti. They are also guru, but guru for dance. पतंजलि योगा गुरु है ना, सूत्रकार फॉर संस्कृत आल्सो भगवान शंकर ओनली गुरु बट दैट इज अनदर फॉर्म फॉर दिस ब्रह्म विद्या हिज फॉर्म इज दक्षिणामूर्ति. So the first Brahma Vidya started from the Bhagavan Shiva, from this Murti only, from Dakshina Murti. Okay. Swamiji, who is the author of this Stotram? Who is the composer? Name of that composer is nothing other than Bhagavan Shankaracharya. Because he only can guess who is that Mahatma. Both are same. Shankaram, Shankaracharyam we say. Shankara Bhagavatpada is the teacher of this Dakshinamurti Stotram. He is the composer. He did praise, stuti to that Guru Dakshinamurti. So, with the help of Bhagavan Shankaracharyaji, we also should do that praise, that stuti of Paramaguru Shankara Shiva. And the title is Dakshinamurti Stotram. Swamiji, what do you mean by Stotram, Swamiji? Two meanings we have. One is, where there is a praise, stuti, that article is called Stotram. There is a stuti, there is a praise. Varnana, glorification we are doing. Generally, wherever we do this stuti, we use one alankara in sahitya. That alankara is called atishaya alankara. Many people, they call it as atishaya alankara, means it may be 1 rupee. For stuti, we say it is 100 rupees, we say. That alankara is called atishayam, exaggeration. Generally, we do in laukika vyavahara, if you want to praise anything, we will add little masala. But whereas Mahatma says, this is not atishayam, this is alpavokti only. Why, Swamiji, this Dakshinamurti Stotram, you are saying alpavokti, we cannot comprehend what Shiva is with one stuti. This is the fact. Whatever we say, whatever even our Guru Shankaracharya, he is trying to say, even that also a little in front of him. Shiva's glory is in Ramayana, they say, Rama Ananta Rama Katha Ananta Amiti Katha Vistar. Tulsidasji, he says, I want to tell about Bhagavan Rama. But Rama, he himself is Ananta Swarupa. How can I frame him? Rama Ananta, he himself. Rama Katha Ananta. Rama Katha means whatever sports he did, whatever leelas he did, they are very deep. Rama Katha Vistar. But I am trying to put him in a book form. It is my foolishness only. That's why doing stuti to Bhagavan Shankara is a alpa vukti only, not atishayam. Then one student asked Swamiji, if you cannot do this stuti of Bhagavan Shankaracharya, then why you have written this? Why all our rishis and munis and gurus and great mahatmas, they compose all the hymns? I know. If they cannot, then can leave it. They say, because of 3 reasons we do this stuti. 3 reasons. What are the 3 reasons? One is, for their own self-satisfaction. Because that Bhagavan is their priya god. If they praise that Ishta Bhagavan, their Atma Shanti they will get. This is one reason. Second reason is for purification of mind. Bhagavat Stuti always purify our mind. That is very, very necessary for study. Purification of mind. Third one is called, it is a gratitude. Kritagnyata. Because we are getting everything because of him, we must remember him. My father only gave all assets and everything. If I don't remember my father, it is completely ungrateful. So my gratitude is I should praise him, I should worship him. So these are the three reasons are there. That's why all Rishi, Muni, Mahatmas, Gurus, they praise Bhagavan Shiva. And another meaning for Stotram, one is where is the Stuti, that particular item we call as Stotram. And in Sanskrit, there is another meaning for Stotram that is called Trayate iti Stotraha. Trayate means which will protect us. If you chant this Stotram, if you learn this Stotram, if you understand this Stotram, that will protect us. It is a shield. That's why if we feel any kind of, you know, bhaya ityadi, we start chanting Bhagavan's name. With the chanting of Bhagavan's name, we will overcome that fear, or we will overcome that particular opposite situation. So trayate iti stotram. Stotra always protect the seeker, the student, the upasaka, the sriddhalu. That's why all Sant Mahatmas, they write these stotrams. Guruji always used to say, a mother takes up his baby and she cleans it very nicely and decorates it, everything she will do. That baby doesn't know what she is doing. The baby may think, you know, she is making me trouble and all the kind of problems. But the mother is making that baby as beautiful. Guru also, with these kind of stotrams, he wants to beautify his students, his seekers. Again and again, he will apply some knowledge, some devotion, some thinking methodology, so that we can catch what Upanishads are saying, or Gita is saying, what is the text is saying. So this is like, you know, baby bath. He says, Guru wants to do baby bath to all his students. So we must worship, we must praise Bhagavan Shiva. Our Mahatma says, there are two kinds of aparadhas we do. Aparadha means mistakes. Generally in our life we do, there are two mistakes. One aparadha is, we don't worship those who are worthy to worship. That is one kind of aparadha. They are worthy to worship, but we don't worship like our parents, guru, any mahatmas. This is one aparadha. Another kind of aparadha is there. We worship them, those who are not worthy to worship. We should not worship them, but we expect something and we start doing worship. Both are mistakes. Surdas ji, one of his bhajan, he writes, hey Bhagavan, me sama kaunu kalakami. Who can be equal in comparison with my crime? Surdas ji says, Hare Surdas ji, what crime you are doing? He says, Harijana Chandi means all the time I am ignoring Harijana. Harijana means who are the devotees and savaks of Bhagavan. Harijana Chandi, Hari Vimukhanako Nisatara Karata Gulami. Hari Vimukhanako, those who are not devotees, those who are not worthy to worship, for them, day and night I am doing worship. All my time I am wasting, Bhagavan, how big crime I am doing. I am like a pig, he says. I am behaving like a pig. I am not focusing on Parimala Dravyam. And moreover, I am focusing on this guttery water. Bhagavan, Krishna, please excuse me. He says, this is the power of worship. We must do worship those who are worthy. We should not do worship those who are not worthy, those who are not eligible. So here, what to talk of Bhagavan Shankaracharya, Dakshinamurti, Bhagavan. He is the God, he is the Guru, both. Hmm. And another doubt also there. Our Swamiji personally he told. Because this Dakshinamurti Stotram is very, very famous in some areas. Some people, they don't know what is there in Dakshinamurti Stotram because it is not a devotional chant. It is a chant with knowledge. Thinking, reflection, those things are needed. So many areas they don't know about Dakshinam. Once they want to conduct a Pooja Guruji Swami Tejo Mayananji Jnana Yajna on Dakshinamurti Stotram in Calcutta. That time our Acharya was the in charge of Calcutta. So they printed Dakshinamurti Stotram by Swami Tejo Mayananji. In Calcutta, lot of philosophies are there. Some schools, whether we can mention or not, that is different. That school people, they came and they asked Swamiji, why you people encourage idol worship? Because the word is called Murti is there. Murti means translation is idol. Why you people, Chinmaya Mission people, generally you people say your Jnana Marga and Chinmayananda is very much Jnana Marga. Then why you people Murti Puja, Murti classes you are conducting? That is a confusion we may have. Which kind of Murti is this Murti? Murti means correct translation is idol, Vigraham. But here, that Murti we are not going to worship. But which Murti, Swami? Guru Murti. Here, Dakshina Murti is none other than Sadguru. No God will take this Guru form. Even Bhagavan Vishnu, as a Rama, as a Krishna, he comes down. For Dharma aspect, he will deal. How people should be, how not, that is okay. But Krishna and Rama, they cannot take Guru form. The Guru Murti, one and only Bhagavan Shankara. Vande Bodhamayam Nityam Gurum Shankara Rupinam. Tulsidas says, the actual fact is every guru is nothing other than Bhagavan Shiva. Vande Bodhamayam Nityam. What is Swamiji? His job, Bodhamayam. Bodhamayam means he is none other than knowledge and his main job is teaching knowledge. That is the main job of the guru. Bodhamayam Nityam Vande Gurum Shankara Rupinam. My Shankara is my guru. To that Shankara Bhagavan, I am doing my namaskar. So with this stuti, we must invoke whoever guru we have. Our guru is none other than Bhagavan Shankara. With his grace only, we are at his feet. If Bhagavan Shankara blessings we don't have, we cannot reach the lotus feet of guru. That is the fact. So we must invoke him. Swamiji. So we know what is Stotram. We know what Murti is this Murti. This is the way we must learn. Stotram, we have seen two meanings. Murti here is Guru Murti. And one other word is there that is called Dakshina. Swamiji, what do you mean by Dakshina, Swami? Why they call Bhagavan Shankara as Dakshinamurti? Very, very important analysis. Our teachers say, this Dakshinamurti word has four connotations. One is, why we call Bhagavan Shankara as Dakshinamurti, particularly in the teaching of Vedanta or in the teaching of Brahma Vidya. This Dakshinamurti, if you see anywhere, his face towards Dakshina Disha. His face towards Dakshina Disha, and the students, those who want to learn from him, they face generally guru direction. Guru direction means they face uttara direction. This way they sit. Bhagavan Shankara towards southern direction and the students towards north direction. That's why they call him as Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti means who is facing the south direction. So what, Swamiji? There is a lot of spiritual significance. They say the southern direction, Dakshina Disha, is the direction for death. Yama is the captain, or Yama is the boss for that direction. This guru, Sadguru, he can face the Mrityu, and moreover, he is Mrityunjaya. Guru should have this qualification. Mrityunjaya. Are you worried of physical death, my dear Guru? No. Are you worried of emotional death? No. Are you worried of intellectual death? No. Why? Because my nature itself Amrutam, where there is no death. Guru can face that death. That's why his name is called Dakshinamurti. In Saddarshanam, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, he says, Mrityunjayam Mrityubhaya Asrayanam. Who is teacher? Beautifully he says, who is teacher? Mrityunjayam. He himself conquered death. Mrityunjayam. Mrityubhaya Asrayanam. But he is giving the shelter to the people, those who are scared of death. That's why students, they are against death and they are facing northern direction. Northern direction means they want to escape from the death. They are scared of death. Mrityubhaya Asrayanam. Because we are beginners. For everything we scare. I may lose this, Swamiji. That losing fear is called death. So, Mrityunjayam. Mrityubhaya Asrayanam Sadgurum. That's why he sits always facing Mrityu, Guru. He doesn't scared of Yama. Moreover, he wants to lift the people, those who are scared of this Mrityubhaya. This is one meaning. Actually, his setup is like that. Bhagavan Shankara in Dakshinamurti form, he sits towards the southern direction. In our Sandipini Jagadishwara Mandiram, but they say because it's a Guru Peetam. The main job of Sandipini is teaching, not Tirthayatra. So there that Shiva, he faces southern direction. Many people, they ask Gurudev, Gurudev, why you kept this direction, Bhagavan? He says he is the teacher. Teacher always faces southern direction and students want to lift themselves. That's why they are Uttara. Uttara means those who want to lift them. This is one meaning. Another meaning. Dakshina means, Dakshina Semoshi Proktaha. In commentary, those who have written Dakshinamurti Stotram commentary, that Mahatma say, Dakshina means Semoshi. Semoshi. Semoshi or Samosa, Swamiji? We know Samosa. There is a meaning called Semoshi, Prokta, Dakshina. Semoshi means Shuddha Buddhi. Shuddha Buddhi. Pure intellect. We call Semoshi. So, if you want Dakshina Murti, you must have this Semoshi Buddhi. Semoshi Buddhi means pure intellect. So here Dakshina means it is a qualification of the student. That is nothing but pure intellect. Shuddha Buddhi. Seeker's qualification. That's why this title written as Dakshinamurti Stotra. Okay. And another meaning is there. This is very popular meaning. We know one word called Daksha. Daksha means very, very efficient. For efficient people, we call he is very Daksha Swamiji. Daksha means very capable, very skillful, very efficient. The qualification of this Daksha is called Dakshina. Means the student is very, very skillful and talented. In Bhagavad Gita also, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, he says, Anapekshaha Suchihi Dakshaha. These are the qualifications we must develop. Anapekshaha Suchihi. One qualification is called Dakshaha. Dakshaha means we should be very sharp, very skillful. In Upanishad, it says, Sukshmaya Agraya Buddhya. Daksha means our buddhi should be very, very subtle. Whatever the teacher is saying, our buddhi should penetrate into that subject. We must penetrate into and we should understand. That is called Sukshma Buddhi. And another is called Agraya. Agraya Buddhi means our buddhi should have that option, I want knowledge. High standards buddhi, that is called. Everything buddhi only asks and, for example, I want best brand of car. That is also agra buddhi only, agra buddhi in cars. I want that brand, Swamiji. Other brands I don't touch. In the same way, I want this knowledge, Swamiji. Other knowledge, I am not that much interested. That buddhi is called agra buddhi. Those who have these two qualifications, he is called Daksha. He can get Dakshina Murti. So this is one meaning. And the final meaning for Dakshina Murti is, Mahatmas, they say, Dakshina Amurti. Amurti means formless. Because truth is always formless. If it remains always formless, we cannot study it. So it has to manifest in a particular form. This Amurti Brahma, he manifested as a guru. That's why they say Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma. This Amurti Parabrahma manifests as a guru. That is called Dakshina. Manifestation is called Dakshina. Unmanifested truth, when it is manifested, then we can call it as Dakshina Amurti. So, this is the complete meaning for Dakshina Murti. Why they call Bhagavan Shankara as Dakshina Murti? Swamiji, you told so much about a little title only, Dakshina Murti Stotram. From where you people got it? Teachers. I know. What is the source? There is a big source is there. One book called Manasollasam. Its title is called Manasollasam. That Manasollasam is the commentary on Dakshinamurti Stotram. Even a little stotram, there is a commentary. Stotram is little, but it is very, very deep. How can you say, Swamiji, it is very, very deep? Because the author of Manasollasam is none other than Sureshwaracharyaji. So whatever we study about Dakshinamurti Stotram, this is all from that Manasollasam. His direct disciple, Sureshwaracharyaji, he has written commentary on Dakshinamurti Stotra. He only brought all the meanings, how to study Dakshinamurti Stotra. Swamiji, by the way, because many newcomers also there, who is this Sureshwaracharya, Swamiji? Generally, many times we speak, we take it for granted. Everybody knows about Sureshwaracharya. But many people after class, they ask, Swamiji, you said some name called Sureshwara Acharya. Who is he? I will tell a little introduction of Sureshwara Acharya also. They say Bhagavan Shankaracharya has main four disciples. Padmapada Acharya ji, Hastamalka Acharya ji, Totaka Acharya ji, and Sureshwara Acharya. Among the four, if you ask Swamiji, who is the best and who is the brilliant? The best and brilliant is none other than Sureshwara Acharya. Sureshwara Acharya is a Pandit class student. Pandit class student, not devotee student. In students also, there are two types. Few students are very much devotion. Guru comes, I will give nice, thali food, this, that. He is different. Another type of students will there. They always study. Pandit. Actually, of course, devotion is great. Nobody can deny that. But he is more worthy. Because he can take guru knowledge for the next steps. Sureshwara Acharya is that type of student among the four. That's why all the commentaries, all the tika, tatparya on Bhagavan Shankaracharya's work, he only did. Sureshwara Acharya. Great scholar. Almost equal to Bhagavad Pada. Other three, they have written just few stutis and stotrams, that's all. But whereas Sureshwara Acharya has done a lot of work on Vedanta. He was a Karmakandi. In traditional forms, he is none other than Brahma's incarnation. Chaturmukha Brahma's incarnation is the Sureshwara Acharya. Shankara's incarnation is our Guru, Shankara Bhagavatpada. He always believes Karmakandi. All Veda is for Karmakanda only. He used to believe. Karmakanda in those days very, very powerful and very systematic, very authentic. Sureshwara Acharya is the captain. Mandana Misra, his name, his old name. India famous. Shankaracharya did not like that because Shankaracharya says, karma cannot give moksham. Jnana only can give moksha. If you say people don't believe, those who are believing karma kanda very authentically, you have to argue with them and you have to take them into your path. So Shankaracharya used to travel. That's why the job of Shankaracharya nobody can do. Those who don't believe God, if you make them believers of the God, that is the challenge. Bhagavad Pada job is, they are very, very learned, scholar people. They say his wife, Bharati Devi itself, likes Saraswati. Nobody can beat the parrot of the Mandana Misra. What to talk of Mandana Misra? Forget about Mandana. That parrot used to defeat many pundits in those days. He used to put one parrot. If you want to argue, first argue with my bird. If you can defeat my bird, then you can enter into my balcony. That great. Bhagavad Pada said, I want to argue. Because my faith is knowledge is final, not karma. So he went to Kumaril Bhatta, who is the guru of this Mandana Misra. By that time, Kumaril Bhatta on deathbed. He is the school master, the Karmakandi master, Purva Mimamsima. He said, Shankaracharya, if you want to establish your this Advaita Siddhanta, the final is that Mandana Misra. He is very learned scholar. You go. If you can beat him, your knowledge will be established. This is the final challenge. You go. And Bhagavad Shankaracharya, he went to that village and he asked, where is the house of Mandana Misra? They used to say, where parrot speaks Veda mantras, that house is Mandana Misra's house. He went and the story started. They started debate. Both are same. One is Brahma Swarupa, another one is called Shiva Swarupa. One is knowledge, another one is Karma Kandi. And finally, Bhagavan Shankaracharya thought. He understood Mandan Mishra and he surrendered himself and he said, I drop karma. I will become sannyasi. Because this Jnana Marga, traditionally they say, this is the Marga for sannyasis. So he dropped complete karma, including wife. He became a sannyasi and he studied and he started appreciating Vedanta like anything. Hare my God. This is the complete depth of Vedanta and he became great teacher. That Mandan Mishra, that Sureshwara Acharyaji, written book called Manasollasam, that is the commentary on this Dakshinamurti Stotra. Why I am saying is, in future, if you get a chance to read that book, you can collect that book, Manasollasam, it is named. You can study. Along English commentaries also nowadays we are getting. So Manasollasam is an authenticative commentary on Dakshinamurti Stotram. This is one. Another great Mahatma, his name is called Swayam Prakasha Yeti. Swayam Prakasha Yeti. In Gurudev's comment, he studied deeply about this Dakshinamurti Stotram and he also written a beautiful comment that is called Swayam Prakashayati Bhashanam. That is also very famous. And one more Mahatma, his name is called Ramatirtha. These are all our teachers, sir. These are all our teachers. From them only how to study Vedanta is revealed. Another Mahatma, great Vedanti, his name is Ramatirtha. He has also written a commentary on this Dakshinamurti Stotra. Even that Mahatma written commentary on Vedanta Sara also. Vedanta Sara is also very, very profound text on this Advaita philosophy. That's how these three Mahatmas, Sureshwaracharyaji, Swayam Prakashayati, Ramatirtha, they are studied this Dakshinamurti thoroughly and they presented what is there in this philosophy of this Dakshinamurti. Our Pooja Gurudev also personally has written commentary on Dakshinamurti Stotra. His favorite book is Dakshinamurti Stotra. Pooja Guruji also written commentary on Dakshinamurti Stotra. It inspires so much. And one more point. Generally, in Dakshinamurti Stotram, there are two parts. One part is called Dhyana Slokams. Dhyana Slokam means prayer verses. Main part is called Stuti. That is about 10 slokas. Dakshinamurti Stotram, it has only 10 slokas. Before that, whatever we have, Vishwam Darpana Drishyamana Nagari starts this Dakshinamurti Stotram. Before that, whatever we chant, we call them as meditative verses or dhyana slokas. In the 10 slokas, 8 slokas only, they speak about this Brahma Jnanam. 8 slokas. That's why some titles they keep as Dakshinamurti Ashtakam. Ashtakam means it has only 8 slokas. But we have 10. 8 are relevant to Brahma Jnanam. And one is Upasana. 9th sloka is called Upasana. What all the Upasanas we should do? Upasana means spiritual practices. And the 10th sloka is called Phalasruti. Phalasruti means it is a blessing. Those who studied this entire stotram, Guru gives his blessings. So this way it has 10 slokas, but 8 only main. Other two are Upasana and Phalasruti. This way, Dakshinamurti Stotram is there. But in our Chinmay mission, we study both. We study Dhyana Slokams and we study main Stotram also. Vijayji, yesterday he asked Swamiji, we study Vishwandarpanamana Drishyase or from the beginning. In our mission tradition, we study both. So in our satsang also, we study both. Please bring your Dakshinamurti Stotram. There is a book of Gurudev, Dakshinamurti Stotram. I posted Dakshinamurti Stotram PDF also. If you have a hard book, that will be very, 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 very nice. Repeat after me. We start from Dhyana Slokam song. Repeat after me. Maunau Vyakhya Prakatita. Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam. वर्षिष्ठान्ते वसदृशिगणैः आवृतं ब्रह्मनिष्ठैः आचार्येन्द्रं करकलित चिन्मुद्रमानन्दरूपम् स्वात्मा रामम् मुदितवदनम् दक्षिणामूर्तिमीडे Actually, what I did is, I broke this line. Actual chanting, now I am doing. Because it will be little easy one. Now you repeat after. Maunau Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam. वर्षिष्ठान्ते वशदृशिगणैः आवृतं ब्रह्मनिष्ठैः आचार्येन्द्रं करकलितचिन्मुद्रमानन्दरूपम् स्वात्मा रामं मुदितवदनं दक्षिणामूर्तिमीडे टुगेदर मौनौ व्याख्या प्रकटित परब्रह्म तत्त्वं युवानं वर्षिष्ठान्ते वसदृशिगणैः आवृतं ब्रह्मनिष्ठैः आचार्येन्द्रं करकलितचिन्मुद्रमानन्दरूपम् स्वात्मा रामं मुदितवदनं दक्षिणामूर्तिमीडे स्वात्मा रामं मुदितवदनं दक्षिणामूर्तिमीडे This chanting itself so nice. Maunau Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam Varshishtante Vashadrushiganaihi Avrutam Brahmanishtaihi Acharyendram Karakalita Chinmudram Anandarupam Swatmaramam Muditavadanam Dakshinamurti Mide Swamiji, Dakshinamurtim Ide. If you see the last line, last word of this poem is Dakshinamurtim Ide. Ide means I worship. This is an old Sanskrit word actually. Eed. If anybody asks you, What is the first word in the Rigveda? They say, Agnim Yide Purohitam. This is the first word of Vedas. Agnim Yide Purohitam. Yide means I worship. Whom? Agnim. वै पुरोहितम् आई एम पुरोहित अग्निम ईडे पुरोहित सी दिस ईडे वर्ड फ्रॉम वेयर ही ब्रॉट ईडे मीन्स आई वर्शिप इट इज लाइक भजे सेवे That way, Ide. Ide means I worship. Whom do you want to worship? Dakshina Murtim. I want to worship or I worship Dakshina Murti. Dakshina Murti none other than Lord Shiva. Bhagavan Shiva. I worship. Why you worship? My dear guru and student both You are worshipping Bhagwan Shiva, na? You are praying Bhagwan Shiva, na? Why? Why means whole sloka are the adjectives for who is Shiva. What are the adjectives, Swamiji? See, Dakshinamurtim Idena. Before that word, what is the word before that phrase? Mudita Vadanam. My Dakshinamurti is... Mudita Vadanam. Mudita Vadanam means very, very blissful faced Vala. We cannot say the exact translation. Muditam means very, very blissful. Vadanam means face. So Mudita Vadanam means my Bhagavan Shankara, my Bhagavan Shiva, very, very sweet and blissful. Mudita Vadanam. Generally, we also smile, we also laugh, we also happy. But if we smile or laugh, sometimes, you know, it is too loudy or too moody. This way we, but see Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi's Prasannata. Tapovanji's face, you just observe for 2 seconds. You know? That expression is called muditam. It is from their fulfillment, from their purnatvam. They will get that expression on the face. Mudita vadanam. Oh, complete joyous experience. Swamiji, how did they get that? How did they get that? Swatma Ramam. They have one thing that is called Swatma Aramam. Aramam means they are resting. They are resting where, Swamiji? They are resting in their own Atma. Their bliss is not because of any object or any person or any situation. Their bliss is because of their own nature is Satta Chitta Ananda Swarupam. They are resting there. They are not resting at the level of mind level, level of intellect level, level of senses level. They are resting at the level of that Purna Swaswarupam. Swatma Aramam. Their own true nature. Upanishad. Atma Kridi and they play by themselves. It's complete Swatma Ramam. That's why they are very, very pleasant and blissful. And Guru needs this qualification. Because student also scared. If Guru also scared, then what shelter he feel? You know? Student should feel, you know, this is very safe place. Because my guru is looking like that. If both cries, then there is no meaning. In the teacher and student relations, this is very, very very good qualification. Teacher, he should have this qualification. He should not depend on any object, person for his happiness. He is happy by himself. Then only he can spread that happiness. You know, student already he is scared. Guru, I want you. If he also can scared, so Guru always mudita vadanam swatma aramam. Swamiji. Okay. What he is doing, Swamiji? Your Bhagavan, Dakshinamurti Guru, what he is doing, Swamiji? See the first line. Maunav Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam. What he is doing is Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam. Prakatita means he is teaching. What he is teaching, Swamiji? Parabrahma Tattvam. Parabrahma Tattva means the nature of Supreme Brahma. He is teaching the nature of Supreme Brahma. Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam. How he is teaching, Swamiji? Maunav Vyakhya. Maunav Vyakhya means his discourse in the form of Maunam. This is the wonder of this Dakshinamurti Stotra. How Shankara Bhagavatpada, he coined this phrase that Guru is teaching Parabrahma nature, Parabrahma Tattvam, but the discourse is completely Maunam fashion. Mauna Vidhanam. Mauna Vyakya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam. Many people, they ask, Swamiji, how it is possible? Generally, if you want to teach anything, you have to speak, you have to move, you have to give directions. There should be a text and everything. Of course, some Mahatmas, they teach this way also. Many people, they say, if you go to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, he is a Mauna Rishi. Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, he doesn't talk, he doesn't speak, always Mauna. If you have any question, and sit in front of him, they used to say that question will be solved in Maunam only. You did not ask, he did not answer also. But still, that question will be solved. How, Swami? Means he is a guru, guru of Supreme. He can do. That is one way. Maunav Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma. Many, many gurus, Mahatmas, they teach this way. This is nothing but some gurus say that they teach from remote. Even if you have any question regarding Pooja Gurudev Swami Chinmayanandi, in due course or in this class, it may be answered also. You also don't know. Brahmachari also did not tell. Book also it is not written, but my problem is solved. So that Vyakhya, Guru Vyakhya has its own sacredness. That is one meaning. But Mahatmas, they have written, what do you mean by Maunam, Swamiji? The translation for Maunam, Bhagavan Shankaracharya in Gita says, Maunam means not to speak. Generally, what we think is, Maunam means not speaking anything is Maunam. He says that is not Maunam. Maunam means Sanyata Vak. Sanyata Vak means disciplined speech is called Maunam. How much to speak, what to speak, where to speak. If you have that discipline, sanyatam, that walk is called, that speech is called maunam, not complete dumbness. Maunam. Our Acharya always used to say, speaking is not a problem, not speaking also not a problem. But speaking with discipline is a problem because it needs a lot of training to speech. Few people only can get, particularly Guru needs that. He cannot speak whatever he wants to tell. There should be a philosophical thinking, text, Guru, whatever, Shishya. So with that technology, Guru is teaching. That is called Sanyata Vak. This is one meaning, Maunam. Actually, main meaning for Maunam is, Maunam means Manana Shilata. Manana Shilata means contemplative nature. Or thinking nature. That nature is called Mananam. You know? Guru should be a mananashili. He should be a thinker. He should be a contemplative teacher. His qualification is called this maunam. Swamiji says, Guru should be always in the mood of contemplation. And that's why great people reading is different. Common people reading is different. The same subject it may be. Because they penetrate into the subject, they ponder over it, they think over it, and they analyze that subject very, very objectively. Because there is no raga, dvesha, ishta, ishta. As it is, they can read it. You know, that is called mood of contemplation. Many people, they ask, what Tapovans Maharaji, every day he sits in front of Ganga and what he doesn't speak and anything, what he is doing, Swamiji, he is doing this contemplation. On the Brahma Tattva, on Atma Vichara, always they contemplate. If you go to deep and deep and deep in the study, that is completely different. I want to tell one incident regarding his contemplation, regarding his mananata. Once Tapovanji Maharaj, he went to Prayagraj somewhere. Many sadhus, they have come. They have different pandals and everything. Tapovanji Maharaj is a realized master. Shuddha Antakkarani, Mahajnani. If you want knowledge, care of addresses, Tapovanji Maharaj. So he visited that particular Tirtham. And by the way, he came to know one great pandit came. That man is very great pandit. Maharaj wants to ask him some questions which are relevant to Vedanta. Maharaj went and he did namaskar. Swamiji asked him, Mahatma, I want to know, what do you mean by moksham? Moksham. I want to know, what do you mean by moksham? That Mahatma, he replied, Vidyate Hrudaya Grandhi, Chidyante sarvasamsaya, kshiyante chasya karmani, yasmin drushte paragare. This is the definition, this is the nature of moksham, which Upanishads prescribe. Because he studied or whatever he reflected. You know, Maharaj said what he said, Tapovanji Maharaj. I am saying what do you mean by reflection, mananam? You know what is Tapovan Maharaj's answer? He said, there is no meaning for moksha. You cannot locate moksha with anything. Then what do you mean it? That is the meaning. Because supreme truths are such. Guru, maunam means always he contemplates. He wants to grasp the truth. That from him teaching coming. Maunavyakya prakatita parabrahma tattvam. And this guru is yuvanam. Here the comparison is, guru is very, very young. And the students are very old. Yuvanam. Guru is young. He is very sharp, very inspired, and he can teach also very fresh. That is, here Bhagavan Shankara is in Dakshinamurti form, always young. Maunavyakya prakatita parabrahma tattvam yuvanam. Oho. Then students, Swamiji, varshishtante. Varshishtante means they are little older people. Why students are old and guru is young? Why they came and what they are doing? Till now we have seen what type of guru we have. है ना. In the next class, we can see in the same sloka what is the qualification of the student. Hai na? That's why Dakshinamurti Stotram is very, very beautiful. Maunavyakya prakatita parabrahma tattvam yuvanam varshishtante vasadrushiganaihi avrutam brahmanishtaihi आचार्येन्द्रं करकलित चिन्मुद्रम आनंदरूपं स्वात्मा रामं मुदित वदनं दक्षिणामूर्ति मीडे. वी विल नो फ्यू मोर थिंग्स इन द नेक्स्ट सत्संग. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.